find the deflection at B for the truss shown in figure by strain energy method. Take E equals 210 kN per millimeter square, A equals 600 millimeter square. So far we have studied how to find the deflection in beams and frames. Now we will study how to find the deflection in trusses. In the strain energy method, first we have to calculate the strain energy, then strain energy in each member, then calculate the total strain energy stored in the truss. That is, strain energy is nothing but internal work done. Then by equating the external work done with the strain energy to get the deflection at the point of application of the load. Here this one is 50 kilonewton. It is subjected to load at B, that is 50 kilonewton in downward direction. Here this one is vertical height is 4000 millimeter and horizontal distance is 3000 millimeter. Here this one is on roller, this one is on hinge. Here he has given area equals area of each member as 600 millimeter square and E as 210 kilonewton per millimeter square. Now first we have to calculate the support reactions. After knowing the support reactions, here the support reactions are by using the equilibrium equations. Here this one is the hinged support. At this point there are two reaction components, one is vertical, one is horizontal. Here by observing this 50 kilonewton, this one is in opposite direction, that is summation of V equals 0, that give us VA equals 50 kilonewton. Both are equal and opposite, that is upward. Then summation of M, A equals 0. Then here the moment to this one is clockwise. Then the moment to this reaction component at roller, that is RC into distance, is 4000. That one is anticlockwise. Then this one equals 0. Therefore RC equals 50 into 3/4. That one is 37.5 kilonewton. That one is acting towards this direction. Then here we have calculated the reaction component at roller. Then summation of H equals 0. Then here the at hinged point there are two reaction components. Here this one is towards right side, this one must be in opposite direction, that is HA equals 37.5 kilonewton. HA equals VA equals 50 kilonewton. HA equals 37.5 kilonewton. That should be towards left side. Now after knowing the support reactions, now we have to calculate the forces in the member. Here this one is 4000 millimeter, this one is 3000 millimeter. Automatically this one is, by Pythagoras theorem, this one is root of 3000 square plus 4000 square. This one is 5000 millimeter. The length of this member is 5000 millimeter and this angle is theta. Then opposite side is tan theta equals 4000, adjacent side equals 3000. Then theta equals tan inverse of 4/3, that one is 53.13 degree, or you can calculate sine theta equals, directly we can calculate opposite side is 4, adjacent side is 5, that is 4/5, that one is 0.8, cos theta equals, that is adjacent side 3, hypotenuse is 5, then that is 0.6. Then after knowing sine theta, cos theta, then you can calculate the force in each members by drawing the free body diagram of the joint. Now we can go for the joint B. Here there are two members connected at B. One is BA, one is BC. This one is, here we can assume the direction of this one as tensile. This one is BA. This one is PBC. Now this is the vertical load. This angle is theta. Then by resolving this along two mutually perpendicular direction, this component is vertical. Then by applying the equilibrium equation summation of V equals 0, then the force in the member BA, that is component along vertical direction, is PBA sine theta. That equals, here this one is 50 kilonewton, this one is joint B, then that one is 50. PBA equals 50 by sine theta, that one is, that is tensile. Therefore PBA equals, that is 62.5 kilonewton, that is tensile. Then summation of H equals 0, we will get PBA. Here you have resolved this. PBA cos theta is one of the component of PBA, just now we have calculated. That equals PBC. Here PBC becomes compressive, then PBC equals 62.5 into 0.6. This one is compressive, therefore PBC equals minus 37.5 kilonewton. That one is compressive. Then here, after knowing the forces in these two members, this one is tensile, this one is tensile, and this one is compressive, that is acting towards the joint. This one is 37.5, this one is 62.5 kilonewton. Then coming to the joint, next joint here, this one is joint B. By the equilibrium of the joint B, you have calculated the forces in the two members BA and BC. Then joint C. Here at joint C, again there are two members, one is vertical, one is horizontal. Here there is a roller support. The reaction from the roller is 37.5 kilonewton, that is towards right side. And this one is the force in the member, just now we have calculated, that is 37.5 kilonewton. Then the force in the member CB or PCB, that one equals summation of V equals 0, no forces, then PCB. Or by relation, if the two members are acting at a point, the force is acting along one of the member, the force in the other member equals 0, then this one is 0. After knowing the forces in all the members, now if you want, you can calculate the support reaction. There is no need of support reaction, but for verification it is better to calculate the external reactions. Then by using the strain energy method, we have to calculate the total strain energy. Then member P, that is due to the applied load, that is in kilonewton. Then force in the member is in kilonewton. L, that is in millimeters, you can put it in millimeters. Then A is given in millimeter square. Then AE, that is you can put in kilonewton per millimeter square. Then millimeter square get cancelled, kilonewton get cancelled, you will get the work done, that is internal work done in kilonewton meter, that is P square L divided by AE. This one is, you will get P is kilonewton square, length is millimeter, then AE kilonewton you will get, that is 2 AE. That is the expression. We have studied the expression for the strain energy in axial member. axial tension. Then here we have to calculate then member AB, member BC, member CA, then the force in the member AB is 62.5, that is tensile, then the force in the member is, this one is negative, that is compressive, then this one is zero, here the length is, this one is 5000 millimeter, this one is 3000 millimeter, this one is 4000 millimeter. Here area of all the members given as 600 millimeter square, that is given. E equals to 10 kilonewton, 210 kilonewton per millimeter square. This term is zero. Then by calculating, this one is the total strain energy, that is in kilonewton millimeter, that one is here 77.5, this one is 16 point, this one is P square, that is P square L divided by 2 AE, that one is 16.74, then the total strain energy is, that is 94.24, then this one is summation of P square L divided by a 2 AE, that one is the total strain energy. In the previous beams and frames, we are integrating the total strain energy due to the bending moment is given by m square dx divided by 2 EI. Here we will take the summation. This one is total strain energy, that one equals summation of P square L divided by 2 AE, that one equals 94.24 kilonewton millimeter. Then external work done, this one is internal work done, external work done, that one equals external work done, that one equals half into P into delta, this one is equation number 2. Then by equating 1 and 2, by 1 and 2, you will get half P is 50 kilonewton into delta, that one equals 94.24. Then delta equals, that is by after simplification, that one is 3.77. millimeters. This one is the solution for this problem, that is by using the strain energy principle. Okay, thank you. We will continue in the next video.